Hello there, welcome back to our YouTube channel CAD Camster. Today we will design this simple open type wrench or spanner in SOLIDWORKS 2018 with the help of some basic commands, and we will see how to create this type of wrench. And I'm going to use this 2D drawing in order to create this wrench. You can see all the dimensions which are mentioned here are in millimeters. So make sure you are working under millimeters gram second system. And before getting started, if you haven't subscribed our YouTube channel, subscribe our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any future notifications videos. Now before getting started, let me go through the drawing. This is the front view of the wrench, and this view is the section view along this center line axis A-A. You can see the thickness of these two portions, which generally holds down the nut or bolt, is 5 mm, and the mid portion thickness is 3 mm. But you can see, and the thickness of this mid portion is 3 mm, and you can see a slot cut out on the top and bottom side, and the cutout distance is 0.75 in both the directions, because this hole is 3 mm and the distance between both these cutouts are 1.5 mm. So remaining will be 1.5 will be divided in two parts. So this cutout depth, which you can see in this isometric view, is 0.75 millimeters, and thus this center, which you can see is lying on this section line axis, is the center of this arc of radius 14.5 mm, and this other center is the center of this arc, which is shown here, of radius 9 mm, same as here. The outer one arc of radius 16 mm, is its center is here, and this center is of this arc of radius 13 mm. So let's get started. So let me pause it and save all. First I will enter into the part mode, go to file, select here new, select part, click here OK. Now let me switch to plain white background and select here millimeter gram second. Now select here front plane, click here normal to, and sketch. First I will create this center line or of length 110 mm. These two ends of the center line will act as a center for these two outer arcs. So select here center line and create a center line from here to up to this one, like this. Now escape, press escape key. Let me off this dynamic input. Now go to smart dimension, select this line and enter the value of 110 mm, like this. Now select your circle command, create your circle, and the circle dia will be 32 mm, because radius is 16 mm. So create a circle, go to smart dimension, select the circle, this dia will be 32 mm, like this. Now I will create this inner profile. You can see, for that create two lines like this one, press escape key, again select line command and create one line like this. Now I will add some constraints. Now select this line, control select this line and make them parallel. Now select your 3-point arc, select this one and this one, like this, create an arc. Now the center of this arc is here, you can see, Now these two lines are not tangent to this arc, so make sure you by default not make tangent relationship. Now you can see from this arc of the center of the arc and this line, it is 8.5 mm and the distance between both lines are 17 mm. So go to smart dimension, select this center point, select this line, this will be 8.5 millimeters like this, and this one from this one, this will be 17. Now again smart dimension, and the radius of this arc will be 13 mm. So select this arc, enter the value of 13 mm like this. Now I will assign dimensions so that I can fix its center. Now go through the drawing, you can see from this center to this center it is 2 mm, or you can say the center of this arc is below 2 mm from the center of this whole circle. So go to smart dimension, select this one and select this one. This distance will be 2 mm. Now you can see the horizontal distance between these two centers is 6 mm, which is mentioned here. Now again select a smart dimension, select these two centers, and their horizontal distance is 6 mm like this. Now I have to assign one more dimensions, the angle from this line to this horizontal, it is 163 mm which is mentioned here. So select this line, go to smart dimension, select this line and this horizontal. This will be 163 mm like this. You can see. Now go to trim entities and trim this portion like this. Now I will sketch the other profile of this one, other half. For that, create a circle of dia 28 mm because radius, 29 because radius is 14.5. Go to circle command, select circle, create a circle. Now go to smart dimension, select this circle and enter the value of 29 mm because the radius is 14.5. So diameter will be touched twice. Now create two inclined lines like this. This is the first one. These two lines will be coincident to this circumference. Make sure you don't add relationship, any default relationship. Now select a 3-point arc and select these two ends and create arc. But make sure you don't make tangent relationship here and here. Now I will add some constraints. Now select this line, control select this line and make them parallel. Now go to smart dimension, you can see from the center of this arc to this line it is 6.5 mm and the distance between both lines will be 13 mm. So go to smart dimension, select the center point, select this line, this will be 6.5 mm. Now select these two lines, this will be 13 mm. Now this arc radius is 9 mm. So select this arc, its radius is 9 mm like this. Now I have to fix its center. For that you can see its center is 2 millimeters above from this major diameter center. Go to smart dimension, select this, let me first drag this center up to here. Now go to smart dimension, select these two centers, this will be 2 mm. Now here you can see the horizontal distance between these two centers will be 6 mm. Go to smart dimension, select these two centers and their horizontal distance is 6 mm like this. Now I have to assign angle. Now go to smart dimension, select this one and this horizontal. This angle is 163 mm like this. Now you can see we have created another sketch. Now go to trim entities, trim this portion. Now I have to assign thickness. For that I am going to use extrude command, but thickness is here, you can see 5 mm at both ends. So go to here features tab, select here extrude boss base. Now enter the value of 5 mm, and this time I'm going to select mid plane. Now click here OK. You can see we have created both the profiles. Now we have to create the mid portion, this one. For that I'm going to select here front plane again and normal too. Now go to sketch and select here center line. Select this center point and snap the cursor on this outer circle, and you can see it is showing the center. Now snap this center like this. This will be 110 mm. Now I will select here offset command to make this 11 mm thickness body. So go to here offset mm, select this line and enter the value of 5.5 mm and select here bidirectional. Now click here OK. This hole is 11 mm. You can see from the center line both are 5.5 millimeters apart. Now select these two profiles and click here convert entities. Now go to here trim entities. Now trim this profile and this one. Now select here 3-point arc, create an arc from here to here, a random arc. Now select this arc, control select this circumference and make tangent. Now again select this arc, control select this line, make tangent. Now add some coincident relationship. Delete this midpoint relationship because this will not be the midpoint. My mistake, I added this. Now select this arc and select this line, make only coincident relationship. You can see it is still free. Now select this point and select this, make here coincident relationship like this. Now I have to assign the radius. You can see its radius is 47 millimeters. Now go to smart dimension, select this arc and enter the value of 47 millimeters like this. In the same way I am doing here. Here the radius is 23 millimeters. Now go to three point, select 3-point arc, snap this point and this point. And go to smart dimension, enter the value of 23 millimeters. Now select this point, select this arc. Select this line, make tangent. Again, select this arc, select this one, make tangent. Now I'm going to mirror these. Go to mirror entities, select these two entities and mirror about this axis. Now click here OK. This profile is at the mid, so I will extrude it about the mid plane. Now we must know the thickness. You can see from this center line these are 3 mm thickness. So go to feature, select here extrude boss base. Now enter the value of here 3 mm. Now expand this select profile. Now select this profile, this one, and these two like this, and select here mid plane. Looks like I made an error. You can uncheck this thin feature. By mistake it was selected. Now you can see it is showing the preview. Thickness will be 3 mm. Make sure you check here merge results. Now click here OK. can see. Now we have to create this slot. For that, select this profile, normal to, and sketch. First, create a center line, snap this, and snap this center like this. Now select here straight slot and select these two points and create a slot like this. Now I have to assign some dimensions. Go to smart dimensions. Thickness is 6.5 millimeters. From here to here, it is 6.5 millimeters. And from this center, it is 28.25. Select this center and this one. This will be 28.25 millimeters. And from the center to center distance, it is 55. Enter the value 55. Now I'm going to use extrude cut. Go to features, select here extrude cut, and thickness will be 0.75 mm because we can see here the distance between the cutout, where the cutout ends and the base cutout starts, or both cutouts ends, is 1.5 millimeters. So the cutout distance will be 1.5 divided by 2 because hole is 3 mm. Now enter the value of 0.75 millimeters. Direction will be downward. Click here OK. Now select here mirror entities and select this front plane to mirror, and features will be this cutout. Now click here OK. Now if you want to add any text in this slot like I have created, you can use wrap command. I'm not going to use make that one. So you can see in this way we can create this simple spanner or open type wrench in SolidWorks. So if you like this video, please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates. Thank you.